They'll do it, sister. That pen there. Amen. I am so excited to be here this morning. So honored, Pastor Ross, Apostle Ross, and Lady Donita, that you would invite me to come this morning. It's an honor. Amen. It's an honor to be honored by the Honorable. Amen. Whew. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Well, there is a word today. Amen. But I want you to turn your Bibles to, you know, I'm just going to talk a little bit as I get started. I'm kind of out of the loop because I've been sitting. I have been sitting and sitting. And I started to tell you, no, Pastor Ross, but the Lord said, say yes. Amen. But because you're sitting doesn't mean you're not in the Lord. It's just you just sitting. Amen. So we're going to turn with me, if you'll turn with me, to 1 Kings chapter 18. I had a word from the Lord after, on Thursday, a couple of Thursdays ago, after I had responded to Apostle Ross. I said, Lord, what do the people need? What am I supposed to talk about? And you know, usually I never prepare in advance, too far in advance. But since I've been a little rusty here, I said, well, let me start seeking him now. And God is so good, because he immediately, in my prayer time, dropped a word in my spirit for this body. And I thank him so much for that. Beginning with the 41st verse through the 46th verse. And Elijah said unto Ahab, get thee up. Eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundance of rain. So Ahab went up to eat and to drink. And Elijah went up to the top of Carmel. And he cast himself down upon the earth and put his face between his knees and said to his servant, go up now, look toward the sea. And he went up and looked and said, there is nothing. And he said, go again seven times. And it came to pass at the seventh time that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea like a man's hand. Glory. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot and get thee down that the rain stop thee not. He said, get out of here before the rain comes down. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heaven was black with clouds. This is from that little hand. And wind, and there was a great rain. And Ahab rode and went to Jezreel. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah, and he girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. I'm going to talk this morning, and before I even do that, let me go on and tell you what I'm going to talk about. The Lord of the breakthrough. He is God of the breakthrough. Where do we go from here? Amen. Amen. You may be seated. The word that God gave me on June the 14th says, and I wrote it down, for those of you who have been praying for particular issues for a long time, And when he said that, I was thinking, how long is a long time, Lord? What do you qualify as a long time? He said it depends on what I say a long time is for each one. A long time for some of you may be a week. Some may be a day because you've been praying all day. Others may be years and you've been praying. But he said, for those that have been praying for a long time, God is about to give you a breakthrough. Manifested answers are coming your way. Manifested answers are coming your way. God has heard your prayers. And he impressed in my spirit. Some of you have been praying for strained relationships. Strained, bad relationships. Answers are coming your way. God has heard your prayers. He's not deaf that he cannot hear. He has heard your prayers. I was impressed in my spirit that he's coming to heal broken hearts, troubled minds. Some sleepless nights about to end. And for others, financial breakthroughs. Look for your breakthrough. Receive your breakthrough. God said that because of such intense attack on your faith that you were about to slip. You were about to doubt him. You were about to fall away. In your spirit, you said, am I one of those that loses my hold, and I'm one of those that falls away? Nothing is too hard for God. He's sending a breakthrough to encourage you in this hour. He said, don't give up, don't lose faith, don't lose your hope. Set your anchor down. Though the winds blow and the storms come, he anchors you. Hold on, don't let go. Hold on, because he is the same God yesterday, today, and forevermore. He's God and he has not changed. He is the prayer hearing, the prayer answering God. He said that when your breakthrough comes, you will know that nobody but him, nobody but God has done this thing for you. Nobody even knew some of the stuff but God. In your secret closets, you sought him out. And he's come because he cares for you. The devil is a liar, tormenting your mind. I don't feel nothing anymore. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. God is getting his church ready. He does not want you to be part of those that fall away. On the news, every day, all day, such discouragement. In the schools, fear, turmoil, discouragement. On the jobs, in the homes. But God says, I'm still God. I'm still God. I am still your keeper. The last thing he spoke to me in that session with him, he said that when your breakthrough comes, now keep in mind, your breakthrough may only be the size or look like the size of a man's hand. Honey, but the clouds about to darken. And the abundance of rain is coming. I said the abundance of rain is coming. Some of the breakthrough may look like the size of a man's hand, and you've got to pray through. Pray your way through. Pray it through. He's encouraging. You've got the strength to stand and to pray and to believe God. He said, if you only believe, all things are possible. Daniel started praying, and he said he felt like God didn't hear his prayer, but he said, when you pray, the angel had a battle for 21 days and delayed the answer to the prayer. But the prayers are being manifested. I don't know what your thing is. They are being manifested. You said, well, Sister Stephanie, I really don't pray. That's okay, because we're going to talk about that. Don't feel left out, without a doubt. Don't feel left out. God desires relationship with each one of us. How are we going to get relationship? Yeah, we can sing, we can praise, but prayer is the answer. Prayer is the answer. You said, well, when God talks, I don't know when God talks to me. Well, you need to spend more time praying. Because when you get before his presence, the more time you spend praying, the more clearly his voice will become to you. You said, well, I pray, and it seemed like I'm just praying to the air. I'm just so thankful for the prayer ministry in this place. Apostle Ross, over these 15 years, you've seen miracles, signs, and wonders. You've seen many things, lady. You've seen many, many, many transformations that have been wrought through prayer. Manifested answers to prayer. Only God could turn things around. Only God could speak to Ronnie O'Mill. Only God. He came in here and he sees something. Amen. Bodies been healed. Lives been turned around. A light in the Delta. Kingdom connections. Woo. God desires relationship with each one of you, young and old. Some of you young folks need to be in your schools praying, standing in the gap, keeping the mentally injured or whatever from coming in, blowing up the building. Young folks need to pray. You need to pray for teachers. You see teachers in distress, other students in distress. Teachers need to pray. Amen. You set the atmosphere in your classrooms, in your building. You do it. You set the thermometer. You don't go and say, ooh, it's so hot in here. No, you are the regulator. The Christ in you is the hope of glory. You said it. The world is in travail, waiting for the manifestation of the children of God to rise up and be who God has called us to be. You are the light to this dark world. You are the light to this Delta. A charge to keep you have. A God to glorify. Yeah, it's you. You. It's me. We were saved, blessed, redeemed, filled with the Holy Ghost to heap it upon ourselves. We are blessed to be a blessing. We can't get in our corners and shut the doors and shut the world out. It's your breakthrough time. It's your breakthrough time. When you break through, you're no longer at the same level. You're no longer at the same place. That last thing that God said to me in that prayer closet, he said, and don't forget to tell them to say, thank you. Thank you. It wasn't the doctor. It wasn't the lawyer. It was you, Lord. You did it. It was you. I give you all the glory, all the honor.
It's you, Lord, and I thank you. He said 10 were healed. Well, the rest of them, they didn't tell me thank you. Oh, yeah, thank him. Thank him. Didn't he wake you up this morning? Start you on your way. Put food in your cabinet. Transportation. Clothes on your back. Eyes to see, ears to hear. Didn't he do it? Woo! Oh, God is good. And he means us good all the days of our lives. Woo! Glory! Don't forget. Don't forget to thank him. Manifest and answers the prayer. Manifest and answers the prayer to your prayer. There's healing. There's deliverance available to you. Oh, yeah. Yeah. To you. You're not left out. If you haven't been praying for a long time, today is a good day to start. It's a good time to start with your relationship. See, we know how to do church well. We know what's going to happen each segment of the service. We know where the church is, how we're supposed to dress. We know when to stand and when to sit. We know when to raise our hands if we're not too bound up to raise our hands. But God desires relationship. Relationship. Relationship with God will change your life. You'll be transformed into that new creation that God has called you to be through relationship. Because see, every time you get in his presence, something happens. When I call him, something happens in his presence. Yeah, you need to experience that. You need to get to know him like that. Instead of just trying to get rid of all this stuff by yourself, things you've tried years and years, time after time, failure after failure. Let God walk you through it. Where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? We are having a breakthrough, Kingdom Connections. It's a time of breakthrough. 15 years. Ministries are shutting down all over the country. Under attack. 15 years. God's amazing grace. 15 years. 15 years. Woo. When I call him, something happens. At the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 2 Samuel, the 5th chapter, verse 20, it says, so David went to Baal-perazim, and there he defeated the Philistines. He said, the Lord has broken through my enemies like a flood. And so that place is called Baal-perazim. Baal-perazim is the named in Hebrew. It means the place of breakthrough. You know, David sought the Lord on how will he win this battle. And God gave him specific marching orders. And some of you need specific marching orders. The specific how to deal with certain situations. The detailed information. They went to battle and they won the battle. Baal-perazim. And next thing you know, here the enemy lines up again. They had a breakthrough. Then the enemy lines up again. What did he do? Where do we go from here? He sought God. God, so faithful. He said, you hear that rustling in the trees. He told him just how to win the battle. As long as he sought the Lord would tell him
how to win the battle. But when he got so big for his own self, he stopped seeking God and lost the battle. Our win is in him. Our win is in him. Lean not to your own understanding. Don't lean to your own understanding, church. It's so much at stake now. So much, too much. Because it feel good, look good, taste good. Don't lean to your own understanding, but acknowledge him in all your ways, and he will direct your path. He is a lamp unto your feet and a light unto your path. That word is real. It says this word is the same. The word is alive and well. There's life in the word of God. Hallelujah. You better know it. You know, the world is trying to dummy down God's word, but the world is a lie. The devil doesn't want you to know the power that you have available. Call those things to be not as though they were. Call it, declare it, decree it. Over your children, over your homes, over your finances. God is the God of a breakthrough, and he does hear and answers prayer. Prayer is the key that unlocks the doors. Prayer is the key that looses the chains of bondage. Prayer. You know, there were other people with prayer. You know, I didn't have her on the list, but that woman with the issue of blood, what'd she do? She pressed her way. She pressed through the crowd. She pressed in spite of possibly being condemned. She pressed her way through and got what she needed from God. She got her manifested blessing. I think of Peter. Peter kept coming up in my spirit. And Peter, he walked with Jesus. He was close to Jesus. And Peter said, oh, Lord, you know, I'm the one. I'll never leave you. I love you, Lord. He said, you know, before the cock crows, you'll deny me three times. And you know what? Peter denied him. Oh, man. And when he came to him, that he had denied his Lord and his Savior. He knew Jesus, but he was scared for his own self. He was scared. He got, let fear grip him and wrap him up. But but when Jesus rose from the grave, he said, go tell my disciples and Peter. Oh, that was Peter's point of breakthrough. He said, and Peter. He said, I haven't forgotten you because you messed up on me. Tell and Peter. Sometimes we are the and Peter that needs to come back to that place. Come back to where God has called you to come. And then what did Peter do after that? When the Holy Ghost came on the day of Pentecost, cloven tongues of fire rested on the people. Tongues of fire. Those stammering lips, those tongues of fire. And people thought they were drunk. They weren't drunk, but Peter had a revelation, a prophetic discernment. Peter came back to where God called him, and he preached that sermon. He preached clarity to what was going on. He preached. He got back on point. And then Elijah enslaved 450 prophets of Baal of the devil. Devil worshipers. People didn't worship God. And then after all that breakthrough, Jezebel said, go kill him. Go kill him. He fled away like a little scared rabbit. Sat by the brook, God fed him there. God sent the raven, the birds to feed him. But then when Elijah came back to himself, he performed signs, wonders, and miracles, raising the dead, healing the sick. Hallelujah. God said, if you've missed your place, you got that breakthrough and you got comfortable in that zone. He said, come back to me. His grace is sufficient. His grace is sufficient. It's no joke. His grace is sufficient. That place where you first started loving God. You know, that place when you came in, you said, oh, God, I surrender all. I give it up, Lord. I don't want it no more. I want more of you and less of me. You know that place? You know that place? You know that place where you turn over at night and Jesus was on your mind? He said, come back, my child, because I am the God of the breakthrough. His grace is sufficient. While we were yet sinners, Jesus died for us. He loves us that much. So, Kingdom Connections. The Lord wanted me to remind you, because I know that you know that He is the God of the breakthrough, that He's still who He says He is. Nothing's too hard for God. Media, ministry, were you all able to find that song for me? Will you just play it, please? I tell you, God, I had to research, what is breakthrough? What does that mean? Whew. Anointing, fresh start, hallelujah, fresh start, fresh start, fresh start, hallelujah, praise God.
Are you ready for it? It's another day.
The altar is open, the altar is open, the altar is open. You've begun a good work, Lord God. You'll see it through.
Come on and extend your hands towards heaven and receive it. Receive it, what has been deposited. God was mindful towards us. There has been a deposit made on today. And the blessings of God are yea and amen.
Hallelujah. The presence of the Lord is in this place. I don't want you to move. Don't stay where you are in the spirit of worship. I don't want you to lose that. But I want to place this in your spirit right now at this time. That breakthrough has come. Amen. And as she was ministering that word, what I saw God planting was bombs. I saw God planting bombs and dynamite in certain areas of your life. Because a breakthrough means that something got to be broken up first. Something has to be destroyed before you can go through. That's the essence of a breakthrough. Once something is broken, now you can go through that. Amen. So be looking for some things to become broken in your life. I mean utterly destroyed, because when that happens, now you can go through. We don't know what be holding us up sometime, but God knows. And when we say, God, we want to break through, then God has to break that thing up. He has to utterly destroy it so you can go through it in the name of Jesus. So breakthrough comes. It's here. It's been coming, but a lot of times we haven't noticed it because we thought it was something that we wanted to keep, but God is trying to break it up so you can come through that. Our prayers need to be, God, break it up, break it up, break it up. Destroy it, God, break it up. Whatever it is, break it up. So I can cut my breakthrough. Hallelujah. 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 It's one thing to come up, but it's a whole other thing to go through something. Amen. I know God would take us up and lift us up, but it's another thing altogether when you can go through something. Because when you go through something, you learn something. I said when you go through something, you learn something. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give God glory for prophetess. Hallelujah. Come on, bless the Lord for prophetess. Amen. Bringing us that word. She brought us that word. Amen. From God. Hallelujah. Hold on to it. Amen. Hold on to that word. Breakthrough is here. It is here. It is going to continue to happen. Somebody say over and over again. Say that over and over again. We just not looking for one breakthrough. We're looking for breakthroughs to keep happening. Hallelujah. Over and over again in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise God.